Well, if God does not exist, then what makes what Hitler did to the Jews any worse than what that raccoon did to the chickens? You know, it's just nature, right? Survival of the fittest. There's no right and wrong.
Mike, I love your ABC method of dealing with emotional doubt, and I think it's super applicable, especially for most of the first world problems that most of us probably experience. But it's hard to get away from the fact that there are many problems which you just can't put a positive spin on. You think of the killing fields, like you mentioned, or the Holocaust. So can you talk a bit more about how you deal with those A events, which you can't just put a B positive spin on, and especially maybe just how you deal with a friend who's maybe just gone through something which, from our perspective, is just impossible to gain a handle or any kind of positive spin on?
Yeah.
Dense.
Well, I mean, we can just say that life does suck at times, doesn't it? It just is nasty. And bad things do happen. In terms of the Holocaust, you know, I've thought about that some. On my 50th birthday, I was over in Germany, and my wife and we were over there with Mark and Heidi Middleberg and their son and daughter, and spending some time. And they said, "What do you want to do for your birthday? Big day, 50th birthday. What do you want to do?" And we were in Munich, and I said, I want to go to Dachau. I want to go to the Dachau concentration camp. I'll never forget it. Why would you want to do that on your 50th birthday? I said, because I'll never forget it. And I went there, and it was just the most sobering day of my life to see the stuff and learn about the stuff that had happened at Dachau. And you got thinking about that, you know, why would God allow something like that? And what would I, something that haunted me then, that haunts me to this day, what would I have done had I been a clergy then? You know, if I come out and speak against the Nazis, I'm going to be put in a camp like Dachau. And speaking against the Holocaust isn't going to do any good. It's not going to do anything. And so all it is going to result in is misery in my life. Plus then my family won't have any income coming in. It's going to hurt them. And you could justify not doing it. It's like, well, I don't know what I would have done. It haunts me. But I get thinking, well, why would God allow something like that? And I remember talking, we had a fix-it man. I am not a fix-it man. I can't do anything. I mean, nothing. And my wife teases me about that. So we got back from Germany, and we had a fix-it man come over immediately to fix some stuff, and he was a Jewish guy. And he said, so what do you think about the evil that happened over there? Doesn't that disprove God's existence? And I said, well, not really. He said, why not? And I said, well, let's just say God doesn't exist, okay? So I was talking to someone, maybe you're in here, I think it was yesterday, where you had some chickens and a raccoon came in and killed all the chickens, you know? And so that was something that happened that put you back, and you'd say, well, but was that a moral evil? And you'd say, no, it's, you know, I feel sad for the chickens, but, you know, the raccoon, it's just nature. That's just what they do. It's not really evil that he did that, you could say. Well, if God does not exist, then what makes what Hitler did to the Jews any worse than what that raccoon did to the chickens? You know, it's just nature, right? Survival of the fittest. There's no right and wrong. I mean, we could invent morals, but it doesn't mean that something is really right or wrong. It just means we've said that we're not going to do this so that we can live more at peace. But there's nothing intrinsically wrong with what Hitler did in killing the Jews, gypsies, homosexuals, and all of that, we'd have to say. Nothing intrinsically wrong with that in a godless reality. So it's more difficult for an atheist to deal with the evil than it is for the Christian. But then I would look at it and say, well, okay, well, how would I deal with it? Well, number one, it does seem to suggest that objective moral values exist, and that cannot exist apart from God's existence. So that's one thing I'd say. Another thing I'd say is, we don't know the plans of God, but we could say this, that was the cusp of the nuclear age. And what if there was a despot like Hitler and this genocide that was taking place had happened hundreds of years, or even just 100, or even 50 years before? It would have taken place, and there's nothing anyone could have done about it. and it would have continued. And, you know, we would have remembered it. There's not much else we could do. What happens, though, is it was on the cusp of the nuclear age, and we were able to defeat Hitler. What if Hitler had those bombs before us? And we might all be living under a Nazi regime today. Things might be really different. So God has his timing and everything, and it may be that he put it just then, Hitler doing this to the Jews, and allowed it to happen just then, so that we would come in and destroy Hitler before he could get nuclear bombs, and it wouldn't be forgotten. It'd be like, we can never allow something like this to happen again. But it would have had to have been at that particular point in history. So God may have allowed something super evil to happen to avoid even worse evil in the future. So, I mean, it's pure speculation. That's all we can do, you know. But that's some of the thoughts that I might have about something like that.